only a major upset if you're from the Sacramento area. Tracy beat Cordova 14-12 right now, live in our Stockton studio with the story, Tom Curran.
Well, that's right, Steve. It was a matchup between two undefeated teams with the underdog pulling off the big upset tonight. We'll go to the highlights from tonight's game between Tracy and Cordova at Modesto Junior College. A big crowd on hand to see this one. And it was Cordova with early problems. A fumble by DeMoy Williams, the quarterback. Tracy recovered on the Cordova 5-yard line, and they were in business right there. From there, it was Raymond Silva who would have quite a night. He took it in from 5 yards out, and it was 7-0 Bulldogs. That was the score at halftime. Third quarter now. Cordova scoring when Tracy Johnson went in from a yard out. The PAT blocked, and it was 7-6. The big play in the fourth quarter right here. Raymond Silva again breaking loose for Tracy. A 41-yard touchdown gallop, and it was 14-6. The Bulldogs led it. Cordova scored late in the fourth quarter on DeMoy Williams' touchdown of 9 yards. It was 14-12, and the Lancers would have to go for 2 points. But it was that decision that cost them the game, probably. The Lancers going for two. Williams was sacked. Tracy had the 14-12 upset and the sack. Joaquin AAA football championship. A big, big victory for the Tracy Bulldogs. They deserve a lot of credit.
Will conclude Friday night when Tracy and Yuba City meet for the large school championship of this area. Stuart Sato tonight has the first in a two-part preview of the finalists.
Downtown Tracy in San Joaquin County. You might not know it by looking at it, but this is the home of champions. These are the Bulldogs of Tracy High, where winning has become a way of life. Winning, like 8 league championships over the last 11 years, like 4 appearances in the section semifinals, and like 1982, when the Bulldogs upset highly touted Cordova High to capture the section crown.
I was at that game, and as a fan, it was just a great feeling. As a player, I can just, it's hard to explain the feeling it is to be in this game.
It was a great win for us, and we were underdogs because of the mystique of Rancho Cordova, and our kids came out and just played a great ball game, and we beat them.
This year's team, 12 wins, just one loss, and one step away from capturing their second section championship. What makes this team tick?
Well, I don't know. It starts out, everybody likes to play here, and we got really great coaches and everything. So everybody just gets into it.
We have a great community support and tradition in this community that football's always been an outstanding sport in this community.
They're not big nor terribly fast, and they don't throw the ball much, but they do know how to win.
The coaches and a lot of fan support, and just want to carry on the tradition.
When you have a winning tradition, you try more.
It's a great thrill. It's like a Super Bowl for the pros or a bowl game for the college teams.
Do you have any message you'd like to relay to the Yuba City Honkers?
Us little guys can hit. That's about it.
The Tracy Bulldogs, a source of pride to this town just south of Stockton. Friday night, a chance to add another chapter to the growing success story of Tracy High. Stuart Sato, News 10.
The Bulldogs have built a 12-1 record, the same as their opponents in Yuba City. However, Tracy has more experience in championship play. It's taken the San Joaquin Championship 8 times over the last 11 years and won the SAC San Joaquin Championship in 82. Coach Wayne Schneider has relied mainly on the running offense, and he's going up against a team that'll put the ball in the air.
They got 3 great receivers, and we're going to have to stop them. One is super, Brian Brown, and then they have a real good tight end, and their quarterback throws that ball well, and so we're going to have to put a lot of pressure on that quarterback, and we're going to have to disrupt the timing of the receivers.
Tracy beat Atwater last week 21-7, although Atwater on the average outweighed Tracy 60 pounds per man. The Honkers too are bigger than the Bulldogs. The Tracy Bulldogs have been facing bigger teams all this season, but what they lack in size, they've been making up for in quickness. Tailback Danley Daniels ran for 250 yards and 1 touchdown in the Atwater game. Even at 5'6", he's Tracy's biggest threat.
I figure once I get past the secondary that I have a couple guys to beat, and I'll think I'll get, if I get past secondary, I'll do pretty good.
The game begins at 7:30 Friday night at the Sacramento State Stadium. in Tracy. I'm Rich Ibarra.
School football section title game between Yuba City and Tracy. Tracy won a thriller, 17-16. We go to Sac State Stadium. It was standing room only. Both cities come out in force, folks. They watched the Yuba City Honkers jump out to a 10-0 lead. Brian Brown, the former athlete of the week, had another spectacular night, almost running this kickoff back for a touchdown. He is spectacular. But Tracy would come back, took a one-point lead, in fact, on this field goal by Donald Patzer. It's good as Tracy leads 11-10 at the half. It stayed that way until 5 minutes remained in the game. The Honkers went to the double reverse. The call went to young Mr. Brown again. Watch him fly down the far sideline all the way for the touchdown. Yuba City went up 16-11 as they missed a two-point conversion. So the Bulldogs had to march the length of the field. Here's the biggest play. Fourth down pass. Steve Thompson and Kevin Rickman for the first down. Then in the final minute and a half, the fake handoff into the line, the pitch wide to Danley Daniel. He turns the corner, the winning touchdown. Tracy wins the section title in a thriller. Is he a happy young man? You bet he is. The final score, Tracy 17, Yuba City.
Obviously, the winning tradition, the dynasty at Tracy High continues as it has tonight, right?
Yeah, I hope it still does. Yeah, it has, and I hope it keeps going.
Congratulate all the outstanding high school football teams around the area for their excellent seasons. The season, of course, came to an official close last week with the Division I Sac Joaquin Section Championship. The winner was Tracy as the Bulldogs edged Yuba City 17-16. Now, our Athlete of the Week is the workhorse of that Bulldog team, and we honor him now as our Channel 3 High School Athlete of the Week. Tracy trailed Yuba City by 5 points late in the fourth quarter. It was a fourth down play inside the 20. The fake went into the line, and then the pitch went wide to little Danley Daniel, and Daniel flew into the end zone for the game's winning touchdown. It was his second score of the night, and he was mobbed by his elated teammates. That score was the difference as the Bulldogs claimed the section championship with a one-point victory.
We rolled down in the first half, and I figured this might be my last high school football game, and I just wanted to go out on top.
So now the championship banner hangs proudly at Tracy High, thanks in large part to a little back. Daniel is only about 5'6 and maybe 150 pounds.
I like to be really elusive and just try to avoid tacklers, squirming through a lot of holes.
We don't even bother looking at size. Any position we have, we don't even look at size. It's just, it's what's inside the kid, the heart that you can't see. And these kids have a lot of desire and determination, and they're just, you know, hardworking kids.
Daniel was part of a Bulldog team that showed tremendous heart all season, losing just one game on its way to the title. Daniel's brother Bond was a key member, doing most of the blocking for his smaller sibling. And of course, they all had their part in the biggest play of the season. Congratulations to our Channel 3 High School Athlete of the Week, Danley Daniel of Tracy.
I paid my dues time after time. I've done my sentence, but committed no crime. And bad mistakes, I've made a few. I've had my shells and kicks in my face, but I've come through. I need to go
on, 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 on.
We are the champions, my friends, and we'll keep on fighting till the goes with it. Thank you all, but it's been no bed of roses.